السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صفيه وخليله، خير نبي اصطفاه، هدى ورحمة للعالمين أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين، أمناء دعوته وقادة ألويته، وارض عنا وعنهم يا رب العالمين. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وأحثكم على طاعته وأستفتح بالذي هو خير. My advice to myself and to all of you to have a taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala openly and secretly. يقول الإمام الشافعي سورة في كتاب الله لو وعاها الناس لكفتهم. الإمام الشافعي said there is a surah, a short surah in the book of Allah. If people understand this surah, if they understand the real and deep meaning in this surah, this will be more than enough for them. Which surah is this? It's a surah al-Asr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started the surah by saying, wal-Asri. Al-Asr mean the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swayed by the time and give a sign by the time of al-Asr. And there is a question here that why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this swear. Time is very important in our life. You as a human live in this time. The real meaning of your life, it's a time. You have now, it's in your hand, and you have the future. You don't have the past. You cannot go back, but you have the present, and you have the future. So your life is about time. This is number one. You have to invest in your time. You have to know why you are here. What is the mission you carried in your life? Ask yourself this question. What do you want? If you go outside and ask people, what do you need from your life? Why you are working? Why you are tired? Why you are running? Why you are too busy? I guarantee most of them, they don't have the right answer. They might give you an answer, but is it the right answer? Now, as a Muslim, you believe in God, you believe in His book, you believe in His messenger, you have the answer. You have the right answer, actually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this reality in this surah. وَالْعَصْرِ by the time, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ. Every human being are loose. Why? Because if a person don't have a goal, there is no clear target, he doesn't know how to get to his right destination. But you know exactly where you are going, because you have a mission. And your mission, the mission number one, you have it in your life, what? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you have evidence? Is there a proof? Yes. Also in very short verse, in Surah Al-Dhariyat, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I only created ins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only created ins and jinn to worship Him. So it's not I'm here for making money or have a big family, fancy car, big house. No. You are here and you have a goal. You are here and you have a mission. You are here and you have priority. And your top priority should be that you want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start our prayer after we say Takbiratul Ihram, Allahu Akbar, by saying the sentence of Ibrahim. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. My life, my death, my prayer, all are for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why you are saying this? Because you have a goal. Why you are saying this, dua al-istiftah fi salah? Why? Because you believe. You have a mission. You have a big goal. Why you say Allahu Akbar? Because you believe that worshipping God is more important for your life, for yourself, than anything else. The word Allahu Akbar, God is greater. You believe in it. You believe that God is, in your eyes, God is more important. You need Him. You need to connect with Him. Now, everyone is loser except those who believe in Him. Except those who have a good deed. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Your life has no meaning if you don't have a good deed. Your day had no meaning if you don't provide something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day you should ask yourself, what I have done for the sake of Allah, for the sake of my nation. This life make us sometimes selfish. We want to do something for ourselves. We don't even think about the others. But in Islam, in this place, Islam in the house of Allah, you are coming here today to achieve the connection with God. Without this connection, your life has no meaning. Even if you have a lot of money, even if you have a lot of power, even if you had 10 high positions, but you still have spiritual needs that you need to fulfill. There is a spiritual life. You feed your body by eating and drinking. Now you have to feed your soul. How to feed your soul? How? When you become a mu'min. When you believe in Allah and His book and His message. You now start, begin your life on the right track. You have going to the right destination. Because somehow, sooner or later, your life going to be end. Your time up. And you will face the real life. You will face the result of your work. You will face the result of how you invested your time. So this is why Imam Shafi'i, in this short surah, and it's a sunnah that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, that we have, after we finish a session or finish visiting or finish when we sit together and everyone wants to go, before we go, we recite Surah Al-Asr. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. It's about reminding. This Quran and this khutbah and the masajid, all about reminder. Remember. Remember why you are here. Open your mind. Open your eyes. You are here for a bigger goal. Shaitan is coming to you. He wants you to see just the dunya. That's it. How much you have money, and what are you going to do now? Quran reminding you on the hereafter. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminding you of the reality of this dunya and what you're going to have in the future. This is why in many, many places in the Quran, Allah mentioned, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. You will not fear the future, and you will not going to be mad from the past. This is what Iman about. This is when you attend Friday prayer or a lecture or someone talking in your religion that going to remind you on the important goal on your life. You have two connections. Number one, with God, and number two, toward others, other human. And this, when Jesus first talked, and he said, وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. The prayer will build the connection between you and God. And the zakah will build the connection between you and others. You have two things to be successful in this life. To build and establish the right connection with God. And number two, to establish the right connection with other people. And you just, what you are doing when you pray, when you give charity, when you fast, when you're going to Hajj, this is just to remind yourself on how to get there, how to build the iman. You have to build the iman inside your soul first, and then you're going to transfer this to others. But if you don't have this meaning in your like heart, you cannot be a da'iya or carrying the flag of Islam, carrying the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is why when you become a true Muslim, a true believer, you will look high from the up. You will ignore any smaller things in your life and just keep staying on the up. You need the high level. Don't say, I just need to enter the Jannah behind the door. This is my goal. No. This is not right. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ الْجَنَّةِ فَسَلُوهُ الدَّرَجَاتِ الْعُلَىٰ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ If you're going to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter the paradise, ask the high level in Jannah. Jannatul Firdaus. You have a big vision. You have a big dream. We need Muslim today believe in this and have the knowledge. We need a Muslim, his action, especially here in America, his action going to be a message for everyone. What is this Islam about? What the meaning? What the goal? Why Islam? People around you, they have, if they know you are a Muslim, they have a question inside themselves. Why Islam? You're going to be the messenger of this deen. But first, you have to build the iman inside yourself. First, you have to have the knowledge, the right knowledge. The right knowledge. The right vision. The right understanding of the Quran, the right understanding of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, you're going to be a messenger. Some people, some Muslims, think that a da'wah just for imam or shuyukh, that's it. No. You are Muslim, you should be da'iyah. You are a Muslim, you should be the messenger of this deen. People now, they're looking at us. And they're observing our action. Be honest. Let them like your deen. Let them like you, like your personality. If they like you, they will definitely like your deen. If they like you, they will like your God. Be positive. And always you have hope. And you have a dream, big dream for the humanity. You have positive vision for everyone. Al-mu'minu khayrun yuhibbu al-khayr. Khayr. Wherever you are, there is a khayr. Wherever you are, there is a joy. Wherever you are, there is happiness. This is very important. We need to go back to the basic of our Islam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started this deen, he started with like the weak people in Quraysh. He didn't start with the revolution and took over Quraysh control. No. He started to build the iman of these weak people. And those become the foundation of this Islam. Think about yourself. And be honest, how attached you are to this meaning. Do you have this type of thinking? Are you asking yourself every day on how you're doing towards Allah? Are you asking yourself if Allah is happy that He's seeing you doing what He wants? Allah gave you everything, and now it's your turn. Your term, we don't need weak Muslim today. It is very important. We need a Muslim with knowledge. We need a Muslim with big heart. We need a Muslim, a strong Muslim. He has trust with God. Trust with God means, like Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his own people thrown him in the fire, and Jibril came, and he said, "Ilmuhu bihali, Allah knows what I'm facing. Yughnini an su'ali." That Allah knows. The answer came from God. قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. This what mean, trust in God. Trust in God, like when you pray or make dua, make prayer, you believe that Allah is hearing you. Allah will answer you. When Allah said, فَادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Call on me and I will answer you. Now there is a feeling with this. Feeling that you feel that Allah is in reality looking at you and hearing your dua. This is what happened when Yunus inside the whale, he said, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. When you say this with trust, with full iman, you will see the result. And Allah said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ. We answered him, we saved him, and now, look, Allah make this rule. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We will save anyone who make this dua. But it should be sincere from your heart. Don't be busy and you don't have time to do everything in your life except asking Allah, except pray to Allah, except thank to Allah. You're doing everything in very good shape in your life except you ignoring the most important thing in your life. When you go to move, transfer from this dunya to al-akhirah, it should be the happiest hour in your life. Because this is what you are working for. This is what you're going to get from this life. If you ignore this reality, everything in your life going to be upside down. You will not see doors open for you. But Allah has plan. You have plan. But be sure and have this trust that Allah has better plan for you. But you only have to worship Him. You only have to connect with Him. You only have to feel the sweetness of Iman. There is a test of sweetness of Iman. When you believe in Him, when you make Him dua, and you feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer you, there is a sweetness. You will gonna test it. Not in your tongue, in your soul. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفروا الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صاحب الخلق العظيم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in the hadith من لم يهتم لأمر المسلمين فليس منهم. The one who doesn't care about other Muslims is not among them. And we all knew what happened in Syria, in Bilad al-Sham, the country that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned and assured us to take care of. And we are here in this community today to ask your support and to seek your help to provide something for your brothers and sisters in Islam. We're going to be here, inshallah, after Friday prayer, have a quick fundraising, and we will have an honor with a big scholar came from overseas, Sheikh Muhammad Ratib al-Nabulsi. He's going to be in this community, in this masjid, tomorrow, inshallah, at 5:30 p.m. So make sure you attend, and make sure you will do your best so your brothers and sisters can get like a basic thing in their life. If you listen to the news, you're going to notice that there's a crisis, a big crisis. And those people don't have anyone to help them except Allah and you. Allah first and their brothers and sisters in Islam and in Iman. So do your best to give the highest amount you can. Because believe me, a dollar will save a life there. A dollar will save a life. The situation there is very bad. We have very difficult situation. People are dying from hunger. Can you imagine in 2017 you have a people in Middle East dying from hunger, dying from cold weather. They cannot find a blanket to cover their children. So please show your support, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you if you are with others. كن مع الله والله في عون العبد ما كان العبد في عون أخيه. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه لكل خير، أراد به غير ذلك فأشغله بنفسه. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، كن لهم عونا ومعينا، كن لهم ناصرا وحافظا وأمينا. اللهم احفظ جميع المسلمين في هذه البلاد، اللهم احفظ أمن واستقرار هذه البلاد، اللهم احفظ ذرارينا، اللهم احفظ أبناءنا وبناتنا، اللهم حبب إليهم الإيمان، زينه في قلوبنا، كره إليهم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، اجعلنا بفضلك من الراشدين، إنك على ما تشاء قدير وبالإجابة جدير، والحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.